Meanwhile, GTM is our set time. Set time.
Listen to me. Things will be happening in your life in the year 2024. Not because you prayed for, not because you ordained for, not because you're qualified for, but because it's your set time. It's because it's your set time. I've heard testimonies, and a man came my way and blessed me with a car. I heard testimonies that a man came my way and blessed me with land. Why? It is because it is your set time.
Pastor, Gwabi, Shuguji. Hata pastor mwenye amechoka. Because ulimwambia, I'm suffering rejection. Edidia, every time you talk, unaumba. 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 Kenyulu, Yesu alikufa. Yesu alikufa. Is there a moment in this life Jesus Christ died? He died. Are you sure? Is there a time on this earth? Maybe I'm going to have my body in that spirit. Is there a time Jesus Christ died? Huh? Jesus Christ never died. Even those 3 days he was preaching. Destroy this temple. And 3 days. In the new opia. Yos kutato likuwa chini. Akiubiri bado injili. A man's belly. Out of my belly, Jos. I love this one. Bimbo, bimbo. Out of my belly. Your riches, everything. Your belly in the spiritual is your handbag, is your bag. Out of your handbag, a man's belly shall be satisfied with the fruit of his mouth. With the fruit of his mouth. Now, pale nimesoma kwamba God planted a garden and the trees brought choicest fruits. Here I'm told a man's belly shall be satisfied with the fruit of his mouth. With the fruit of his mouth. A man's belly. A man's family. A man's house. A man's handbag. A man's treasure shall be filled with. A man's belly shall be satisfied with the fruit of his mouth. And with the increase of his lips shall he be filled. Increase. Meaning what? Speak big, sir. Increase your lips, not to eat a bigger chunk of ugali, not to eat a bigger chunk of nyama choma. No, but increase your lips to speak big by the capacity of your God and who created you. And Adam was bought everything, to name everything. And whatever he named anything, whatever he named, he became. So go to your compound and name things. You are foolish to name your child after your mother, after your shosho, meaning what? All that you have seen and all your child will be is your mother. And your mother died a pauper. So you have brought forth another one and you have named your child after your mother. Today another pauper. So I've given birth to another pauper. Another beggar. Thou shalt not be a beggar. Thou shalt not be a beggar. A man's belly shall be satisfied with the fruit of his mouth. Let your mouth speak. Verse 21. Let's imagine. Death. Doctor, inside the upper. Death. Sir, there was no death until Adam said it. Death and life. Death and life are in the power of the tongue. Life and death. Haiko popote pale. The power of life and death is in your tongue. And they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof. Shall eat the fruit thereof. May everything in your life be contaminated, but not your tongue. Amen. Hallelujah. James chapter 3, 5 to 10. Before you go to James, Psalm 64, 1 to 3, amplified. Hear my voice, O God, in my complaint, guard my life from the terror of the enemy. Listen, where is the terror of the enemy? Hear my cry, I'm a complaint. Hear me. Verse 2. Hide me from the secret counsel and conspiracy of the ungodly. Every conspiracy of the ungodly, from the scheming of those who do wrong. Verse 3. Who have sharpened their tongues like a sword. They aim venomous words as arrows. They aim at your heart, and out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. So if people are aiming at your heart with words, sir, before long, you'll behave what they're saying. You'll become what they're saying. Who have sharpened their tongues like a sword. They aim venomous words as arrows. Every morning, pair up. And that's why every day say here, on this altar, in God we shall make it. In God we shall be a name. In God we shall be a landmark. Every day speak to yourself. So free. Every time you are speaking, you are creating. Every time unapongea, unaumba vitu. Siumbe vitu ambavyo vinavaa. Venomous arrows. Jeremiah chapter 9, 8 to 9. By one will be done. And we call it a day to the glory of God. Jeremiah chapter 9, 8 to 9. NLT version. NLT. People words influence your word. People words influence your world. And their words have power. And that's the way God meant it. Don't allow people to name you. What do people say I am? Oh, when Elijah, when Jeremiah, Peter, no one has a nini. You are the son of the living God. You are the Messiah. Flesh and blood have not revealed this to you, but the Spirit of God. And upon this rock, not upon you, upon that truth, I'll build my church. I'm the Messiah. Meaning what? That one I admit it. I'm the Messiah. And upon this truth, I'll build my church. Yesu akubali kuitwa Elijah. That was downgrading him. You have allowed people to define you. You have allowed your parents to define you. You have allowed people to define you by where you come from. Who you pastor kutoka Narok? Haka masaika Narok? Haka keupe? Ka pastor kapale juu? Haina shida? You might think, then God, this body came from Narok. But the thing in me is not from Narok. Jeremiah, for their tongues shoot lies like poison arrows. Tegak. Kunat waongo. Ajajaja. Waongo. My friend, you don't change what is already in the past. You can only speak what will be in the future. Stop lying. Mama anga yuko Kenya ko US. My mother is not in US. Ako Narok. But I can change the status in Narok by the way I speak. He brought everything to Adam to see what Adam will call it. Where are you right now? What are you calling that thing? What are you calling it? Mungu alimletea Adam kila kitu in a jelly form kind of thing. Kama watoba nje kauka. Adam shaped it now. You'll be like this. Be like this. Because all of them were in the same place. Garden. Hapa. Akaekelea hapa. Adam, unasema nini? Let us create man. And because I'm busy, I'm the boss. Tukwenda kaprinda. Kakuprint hii wanyama. Print Simba, print nini. Akajachilia. Have you ever read about Branham? Have you ever read about that man? Branham. Branham could pray in the order of Elijah. Elijah alilani watoto. I curse you in the name of the Lord. Then what happened? Two she bears. Silitoka wabi? They must thank you. Pastor Paul. Elijah. Pastor Elijah. Children were mocking him. Were they 42 or 43? 42. Were mocking him. And he said what? I curse you in the name of the Lord. What happened? Kill them. All of them. These two she bears came from where? These two she bears came from the tongue of Elijah, sir. He created a little picker, two she bears. Every time men speak, wanatapika wanyama. Kwa maisha kuna watu wametapikia wanyama. Unatapikiwa vitu. Na umekubali. And when you get born again, you shall not go back to your vomit. Jeremiah, please. For their tongue should lie like poisoned arrows. They speak friendly words to their neighbors. They speak friendly words to their neighbors while scheming in their heart. Elijah schemed in his heart to kill the children before they died, sir. Tayari, Elijah had a bear in his heart. Alipoongea akachilia two she bears. She, not he. She. Akachilia. Two she bears. And smart. Amos. Ajuna Vendai. Two she bears. While screaming in their heart to kill them. Verse 9. Should I not punish them for this? Says the Lord. Should I not avenge myself? So they speak lies. Then God says, will I not avenge for myself? Will I not avenge? See that began here? Will I not fight for myself and avenge? Should I not punish them? So what, please take me to verse 8. To 11. For their tongues shoot lies like poison arrows. They speak friendly words to their neighbors while scheming in their heart to kill them. Then he goes ahead to say, should I not punish them for this? Says the Lord, should I not avenge myself against such a nation? They were friends talking to their neighbors. All of a sudden, they have changed into a nation. So, nation, why? Because what is being produced is a multiplication of wickedness. A multiplication of evil. You can be alone here in the church, but you are multiplying a nation of wickedness in the church. You are multiplying a nation of discord in the church. He says what? Should I not punish them for this? Meaning what? Nina duplicate. Nina, kwa kipasai. Duplicate.
Kenyanyuk.
Bas. Kenyanyuk. So, unakuta mutu ana duplicate vitu kama ye. A disuniter. The thing is going on. A distributor. And you are just saying, maneno yako sio mkuki, hata ni utajua ndio hii. And then God says what? Should I not punish this? Says the Lord, should I not avenge myself? What can you mean what? Let me fight for myself now. Because these people have become great and they are becoming a nation inside the church. Becoming a nation against you. That's why there are some people in Gong Masidaisa. God, the more they are doing it, the more they are multiplying. Unakuta, duka, ya Millicent, nimbaya. Amea moja. Unakuta, it multiplies to a point that you make your food, nobody's buying. Why? Because it's a nation now against an individual, a conspiracy. Meaning what? Wamejiumba chuki. Unakuta, Pastor Paul, before you defend yourself, sir, you'll have to enter all those people and remove and erase all that, sir. So you have to pray. And not a prayer. Thank you, sir. The woman was caught in the act of adultery, sir. We are not all of the man. We are not all of the man. The woman was caught in the act of adultery, and she was brought to Jesus Christ. She was brought. This one, we caught her. Meanwhile, the tree of death, conscience, was now working on her and against her. People had already created death for her. Already. Stoned her to death. Sir, where was the man, sir? What's the man? There was nowhere. And Jesus Christ stooped down, wrote down, and they read, they uttered, Akainama tena, Akandika upia, blotted out. And the woman, your sins are forgiven. Go and see no more. Lest a worse thing than this happen to you. Starting from the old. They left starting from the old. Because alipoandika chini kento aliposoma alijiona mwenyewe. Si leo si alike chini leo. Wacha kuniona. Wacha kuona wengine jione wewe mwenyewe. Haya maandiko ni mira. When you see yourself in a Didia, utachana na mimi. When Dr. Emmanuel sees himself, he will leave you.
Yes, sir. Hallelujah. Yesu asifiwe. Now take me to the book of James, chapter 3, 5 to 10. This one. So, please hear this. Even so, the tongue is a little member, a little printer, a little creator. Even so, the tongue is a little member and boasted great things. Behold, how great a matter a little fire kindleth. Even so, the tongue is a little member of the body. Nikadoko! Gitogi. Verse 6. And the tongue is a fire. And the tongue, not like. So the tongue. The origin of fire is in your tongue. And the tongue is a fire. A world of iniquity. A world of iniquity. So is the tongue. Nipati ebu tipiti. Kwa vile natuwa utamu vizuri. Kwa hili neno. Tipiti kwanzia mstari wake wa tano. And so the tongue is a small part of the body. Yet it carries a great power. Just think of how a small flame can set a huge forest ablaze. Verse 6. And the tongue is a fire. It's a fire. It can be compared to the sum total of wickedness. Pastor Paul, if you want to know the sum total of any mass wickedness, allow the person to talk. The summary of wickedness is in the tongue, sir. The summary is not in handwriting. My friend, their words. There are people who will drive you by their words. And their tongue is a fire, it can be compared to the sum total of wickedness. And it is the most dangerous. Women, let me help you today. Samson was not destroyed by the thighs of Delilah. Baba yata. Satan. The tongue. Delilah! Hakumaliza Samsoni na mapaja. Samson. Go and read your Bible. Judges chapter 16. What can I do to destroy you? Sir. What? And he vexed his soul. He vexed him. He vexed him. Do you vexed him? Ni torment ya pepo. Ile ya pepo inakuangisha usiku na mchana. And Delilah vexed him to a point that Samson had to say, ukinikata nywele nimekufa. And sometimes people can vex you. Vexed. Sir, the tongue is the most dangerous part of the body of a human being. Then he says, it corrupts the entire body. What is the church again? Church. Mrs. Kemboiwe. What is the church? The body of who? Major Biblia Njere. It corrupts the entire church. And it is a hellish flame.
Unakuta kanisa inatishiwa moto. Some people are waiting for hellfire. Hellfire is already in your mouth. Hellfire. Hellish fire. Hellish flame. It releases a fire that can burn throughout the course of human existence. Huyu ulimi yako sasa itapangusa binadamu yote. The existence. Sir, it is the tongue, sir. Sir, today remove this corrupted mentality that Adam and Eve had sex. Please, when in Toto Ashule. Go back and read them. That was not the cause, sir. There was not any other woman, sir. There was only one woman who was created for Adam, Eve. Only. And she was created purposely for that. So don't say that was the cause, sir. That wasn't. But Eve was corrupted. The tongue was corrupted and affected the entire human existence. You are poor because there was somebody in your lineage whose tongue was corrupted. Anybody will be called my name atolewa tena. Because mimi nilipigwa na babu yenyu. Nie washera. Wakenodia. Wakangoro. There's nobody with my name will ever be married by any man. Yakuta washera wote. Washera. Wakangoro. Wakaduadua. Hakuna! The entire lineage in Omiya. Entire lineage in Omiya. It says fire that can burn through the course of human existence. Then it says, verse 7, for every wild animal on earth. Ten. Why? And you gave man power over all the animals that you created, birds and fish and kila kitu. Then it says, For every wild animal on earth, including birds, creeping reptiles, and creatures of the sea and land, have all been overpowered and tamed. By who? Genesis 1 again. Then again, Garden of Eden again. Then he says, verse 8, but the tongue is not able to be tamed. It is a fickle and restrained evil that spews out words full of toxic poison. Verse 9. We use our tongue to praise God. As if you were Mokosi, as if you were. And then turn around and curse a person who was made in his so many words. Even what is created in the very image of God can be cursed by a man. Because man have got that potent and that potency and that inherent power. May God help us. May God help us. Praise the Lord. What are we fighting? Nikimalizi in the book of Galatians chapter 4. Today there's something I want. Today it struck me, sir. It struck me so hard. Give me 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 9 to 10. Every time, Pastor Paul, you're in pain, I'm in pain, Satan brings a wife called Hagar. Nungapi mbaka lewe muna lao mungi yu mutu anetua Abraham. Tuyo Adam mungine, Abraham. Baba imani. Nungapi wana mula umu. Ero, kakuya, amasa, kakuya. Abraham, kakuya. Kama tuunge gusa Hagar. Hawa tu anetua Ishmael hangi kwa. Nungapi? Sometimes unasikama utalaumu Abraham. Ishmael hangi kwa yeko. Hatuunge angaika. Joy, ni kweli? Kama Abraham angekutana na Hagar. Unajua Hagar ni nani? Hagar is a painful season in your life. Hagar is a painful season in your life. Hagar is your season of wilderness. Hagar is your season of waiting. Hagar is your season of stagnation. Hagar is your season of delay. Hagar is that season. And Hagar utazana ye. Hagar utazana ye. Na majabu ni kwamba utampachika mimba. Na baada kumpachika mimba atazaa. Na atazaa Ishmaeli. Na utakapopata hadi za Mungu maishani mwako, utakapofika pale ambako Mungu alikuwa amekuahidia, Ishmaeli atakuangaisha. Ishmaeli atakuangaishia Isaac.
Andika.
Haggai is a season.
A season of waiting.
Ngata kwenye kitu tutasala leo. Na ile kitu umekukiza. Nikuonyeshe leo so that utaenda wewe mwenyewe. Wewe mwenyewe utashughulikia Ishmaeli kuanzia leo. Utajua Ishmaeli si Mwarabu. Na uli mzaha.
Maneno.
Words are life. Some of us, we are a reminder of pain to our parents. And what they named us was a reminder of what we are going through with Hagar. Let me show you one. Jabez cried out to God, to the God of Israel, saying, "All that you will indeed bless me." Give me verse 9, sorry. Verse 9. Jabez was more honorable than his brothers, but his mother, he was honorable. Alikuwa na potential. Meaning what? You can be caged. You have got a potential and greatness, but be caged in the name that Adam will call you. Be caged in the name that a man will call you. And whatever Adam called any animal, that animal became it. So meaning what? What did your parents call you? What is any man calling you? And Jabez was more honorable than his brothers. But his mother named him Jabez, saying, "Because I gave birth to him in pain." So Jabez was a reminder of pain. That came with Jabez. But Jabez, like me and you today, what happened, verse 10? Jabez cried out to God of Israel, saying, "All that you will bless, you will indeed bless me and enlarge my border, property, and that your hand will be with me and you will keep me from evil so that it does not hurt me." My birth was a hurt. My birth was a reminder of pain to my mother, and she named me pain. So therefore, everything I'm experiencing in life is nothing but pain. What are you called? What have people called you? Jabez, maybe. There's also another man called Ichabod. Because the presence of Israel, the presence of God, have departed from Israel. Ichabod. Some of us, we are called Ichabod. Galatians, Kimalizia. Wewe ni kiumbe ambaye, ni kiumbe majabu. Mtoto anapofanya makosa, Pastor Paul, huwa tunamchapa. Ni huu mwili. Lakini mtu wake wa ndani hachapwi. Ni maneno. And words had a direct impact to the spirit. It crushes the spirit and the soul. It crushes. A child cannot die by beating. Can die. But a child can die because of words. It crushes. Let me show you something today. Give me the TPT version. TPT, Galatians chapter 4, 21 to 31, as we stand to pray. Today, nataka ushugulikie mtoto wa Hagar. Atakuangaisha. I told you to destroy their altars and their pictures, their molten images, their idols. I told you to destroy them, but you never destroy them. But they will become thorns and briars in your life. They'll torment you. Hagar. Ishmael. Ni mangapi ulipokuwa kwa machungu uliyasema, ulizaa, na Ishmael anatembea, atakuangaisha. Isaka atakapofika, atakuangaisha. Ni ulimzaa. Tell me, do you want to go back to living strictly by the law? Haven't you ever listened to what the law really says? Have you forgotten that Abraham had 2 sons? Abraham, one by the slave girl and the other by the free woman. One by the slave girl. So he was in slavery and slept with a slave girl. And what was born? 21 verse 22. Ishmael, the son of the slave girl, was a child. Acharabosa. Hoy. Kama umenishika tu. Umenielewa. Was what? Pastor Paul. Ishmael was what? Ishmael, the son of the slave girl, was a child of a natural realm. Not a natural body, natural realm. But Isaac, the son of the free woman, was born supernaturally by the Spirit, a child of the promise of God. So we have got two realms here. Abraham, same man, gave birth to two sons. One son, the natural realm. Number two, the supernatural realm. Sasa majabu ni kwamba, when Abraham was waiting upon the promises of God, in pain, waiting, in delays, in stagnation, Abraham impregnated a slave girl in complaints, in murmurings, and all the children of Israel who left Egypt and complained and murmured in the natural realm never entered the promised land. Every Ishmael will never see the promised land. Ay, 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 ay. Wakati kwa machungu. Wakati kuna uchungu mama unaongea. Wakati kuna uchungu baba unaongea. Wakati kuna uchungu unaongea unazaa. Na nakuambia Ishmaeli ni wako. Haitatanishwa na mimi. Ni wako. Ishmael. Wakati mnapitia magumu unasema nini? And Satan knows. This is a girl. That girl called slave girl. Slave girl have got nothing. And they have got nothing to lose. They have got nothing they own. They are waiting for you. Tumezalisha mambo mangapi kwa machungu. Tumeongea mangapi kwa machungu. Hoi maskini ya Yesu. Mungu nisaidie, sijui nitafanya nini. Sijui nitafanya nini. Umekuwa na haga. Na huyo ndio bibi yako wa kwanza. Na yale yote ambayo umekuwa ukiyasema uliaza. Na yamezaliwa na yanakuandama, yanakuita dadi. Ishmael ni mtoto wa nani? Ishmael alimuita Abrahamu nani? Alimuita nani? Ubarikiwe. Ali, thank you. Alimuita baba. Ni wangapi ambao nakuita baba leo hii? Ni wangapi ba kwa machungu? Uliwaumba kwa bitterness, uliwaumba kwa wivu, uliwaumba kwa jealousy, uliwaumba kwa discord, uliwaumba kwa disunity. Ni wangapi ambao uliwaumba? Leo hii wanakuita baba. Leo hii chuki inakuangalia kwa uso, inakuambia dadi, niende wapi? Na ulinizaa. Niende wapi? Mimi fukara, niende wapi? Dadi, uliniumba, ulinizaa, niende wapi? Nimkimbilie nani? Kanisa la Bwana, tunakuliwa na watoto ambao tumewaza kiroho.
Every time Pastor Paul is speaking, you are having an intercourse with the spiritual world.
Kabla kuokoka ni nini? Kuokoka ni kubadilisha maneno. Changing your talks. Because every time you are talking, you are having a spiritual intercourse. And you are having a spiritual intercourse with a slave woman called Hagar. Na nakuambia Hagar ni mzuri, hata toroka. Hata kuleta toroka hote. Unapopiga magoti Pastor Vincent, umeinua mikono juu. Toto tuko hapa hivi tu haga. Daddy, fukara, magonjwa, nini? Yote uliumba kwa machungu. Cause haga ni mke ambaye umekuwa ukilana na yeye. kwa kuongea kwa machungu. Hii ngong sitainuka, hii ngong sitakuwa, mashamba ni gali, sitaendesha. We, endelea, wanazaliwa, wanazaliwa. And before long, they'll overcome you, sir. Akasema hivi, these two women and their sons expressed an allegory, and become symbols of two covenants. The first covenant was born on Mount Sinai, birthing children into slavery. The first one is an allegory, a symbol of children who are born on Mount Sinai, birthing children into what? Birthing children into slavery. Children born to Hagar. Your careless talk. Your negative talk. Kuna mtu ulimpachika mimba. It was a one night stand out of anger. But msichana mwenyewe akashika mimba. Leo amekuja amejaa mimba imeshona. Na anazaa tu vitu. Unakuta ni nini hii? Umaskini unakuita baba. Uchochole unakuita baba. Kansa inakuita baba. Uliza kwa uchungu. Kwa machungu kuongea kama Mungu yuko ni muongo. Huyu Mungu aponyi na hakomboi. Ulisema nini? Na umekuja kanisani, umegongwa na maisha. Yule mtoto ulizana Haga ni kwamba hutaiponywa. Hata lipi lifanyike. Haga. Ni mangapi? Tuendelee, inasemaje? Verse 25. For Haga represents. So Haga is not true. Haga is a representative. Haga represents the law given at Mount Sinai in Arabia. The Haga metaphor. Walimu nisaidia ni metaphor. Ni ilikuwa kitu gani metaphor? Metaphor ni nini? Nejo metaphor na symbolic. Ishara. Metaphor corresponds to the earthly Jerusalem. Iko hapa Kajiado. Jerusalem. Metaphor. Earthly Jerusalem of today who are currently in bondage. Currently. In bondage. Verse 26. In contrast, there's a heavenly Jerusalem above us, which is our true mother. Which is our true mother. She is the free woman birthing children into freedom. Salvation. I'll be great. I'll be mighty. I'm able. Birthing our children into liberty. Birthing children into freedom. May God birth you. May your destiny be birthed from today. Amen. Into freedom. Amen. Wacha kulala na Haga. Ambia mwenzako hivyo. Wacha kulala na Haga. Na kuzaa watoto wa kuhangaisha. Stop speaking negative. Listen. If only you can mark these words. Every time you speak, you are having a spiritual intercourse. It's either you're impregnating for slavery or for freedom. Then, verse 26, 7. For it is written, burst forth with gladness. This idea here to Leo. I've never understood this scripture until this morning. For it is written, burst forth with gladness, O barren woman, with no children physical. Break through with a shout of joy and jubilee, for you are about to give birth. The one who was once considered desolate and barren now has more children than the one who was a husband. I've never understood this scripture till today, sir. Kuja hapa hivi. Bibi aliena. Mwanamke aliyetasa. Aliyetasa. Where is your tasa? Not one day. Metaphor. Mwanamke aliyetasa na ambaye hajaolewa na Sasa, now, neke Kiswahili ibu pengine itanisaidia. 27, Kiswahili. Kiswahili, Kiswahili. Kama itanisaidia mahali. Kama weke ya kimasai ya makikuyo. Mana, imeandikwa, furahi ewe, ulie tasa, usieza, paza sauti, wewe usiepata kujifungua mtoto. Mana, watoto wa yule, aliyeachwa ni wengi kuliko wa yule aliye na mume. Mtoto Haga, mtoto wa yule ambaye aliachwa ni wengi. Watoto wa manunguniko ni wengi. Wakati unapopitia magumu na mazito, mara nyingi watu wanungunika. Na watoto wa manunguniko wa mwanamke asiyekuwa na bwana ni wengi kuliko aliye na bwana. Ni wengi. Meanwhile, a woman with a husband satisfied, okay and settled, her children are fewer compared to a woman in barrenness and in murmuring and in complaining. Mana watoto, wa yule aliachwa ni wengi. Kwa anaongea sana. Anaongea. Ana majuto. Uliza wakati huo. Give me the other fashion. Ugo. Now has more children than the one. Sir, how does a woman who have got no husband have more children than a woman with a man to impregnate her? Why? It's because you don't need a man to have children in this realm. You don't need to. Just need to speak. Sema hivi, wale watoto wamenizingira. Mimi niliwaza. Nitawashughulikia kutoka leo. Sema nitawashughulikia. Kama ni wakuua ndaua. Kama ni wakwenda waende. Ishmael aliambia nini? Let her go. Let Hagar go. Ulipookoka ulisema Hagar go with her children. Ukampokea Sara ambaye ni Yesu Kristo. Na Isaka, metaphor, ni Yesu. Kuanzia leo hii GTM, tumejizalia watoto na Hagar. Manunguniko, vitisho, chuki, wivu. Leo hii wivu na kuangalia kuita dadi. Hapo nasema verse 28 nasemaje? Dear friends, just like Isaac, we are now the true children who inherit the kingdom promises. You cannot inherit the kingdom with a wrong tongue. The children of a slave woman cannot inherit the kingdom, cannot inherit our father. Then he says, dear friends, just like Isaac, we are now the true children who inherit the kingdom promises. Verse 29. And just as the son of the natural world at that time harassed. Ni wangapi ambao kanisani unaharasiwa na mapepo? Unapenduliwa usiku na mchana. And just as in the days of Abraham, Hagar, and Sarah, and just as the son of the natural world at that time harassed the son born of the power of the Holy Spirit, so it is today. A son born of the power of the Holy Spirit is being tormented, being harassed by the son that is born in the natural. The lowest realm, the natural realm is disturbing the born again. That's why today the born again cannot make it. Why? Tuliza na slave girls. I'm a slave girl. All of us. I include even women. Please allow me here. Meaning what? Hagar corrupted Abraham. Abraham slept with her. And that notion, because Isaac was never to taste any hardship. And that's why in the same land, he sowed seeds. And in the same land, he harvested a hundredfold. But this son, the sons of the Philistines, they came after Isaac. And every well which was dug by the father, they buried it until Isaac went 1, 2, 3, 4. Until Isaac reached a point where it's called Rehoboth. Meaning what? A change of language. A change of story. A change of talk. No more negativity. No more failure. No more rejection. No more retardation. No more pain. In the name of Jesus Christ. A change of story. God, bring me to my Rehoboth. Bring me to my Rehoboth. Where I shall speak what I ought to speak. And the natural son will no longer destroy me. Will no longer destroy and bury what God ordained for me as a son. Hallelujah. And just as the son of the natural world, at that time, harassed the son, born of the power of the Holy Spirit, so it is today. So it is today, sir. Tunasumbulona achawi. Tunas natural. 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 Wachawi wameingia kanisani. Natural. Wanatuangaisha. Tunazaa na wao. Tunaongea na wao. Wanazaa vitu. Ambavyo hatuna amani tena. Natural. Natural. Harassing us. And the Bible says, born of the power. Born of the power. Born of the power. Born of the power of the Holy Spirit. So it is yesterday. So it is last year. So it is last weekend. Oh my good God. So it is 10 years ago? No. As it is today. As it is today. 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 What's that? Oh my good God. And what does the scripture tell us to do? What does the scripture tell us? What does the scripture tell us? What does the scripture say? Expel the slave mother with her son. The son of the slave woman will not be a true heir. For the true heir of the promises is the son of the free woman. Today, waging warfare. Expel. 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 Rospa, unapongia unomba, unomba. And that's why the Bible says in the book of Ephesians chapter 6 verse 12, for you are not wrestling against flesh and blood, but against persons without a physical body. We are fighting wars. You will, where we're soma, you will never drive. And you think they are joking? They are children. And they know who their father is. They'll follow you. A child knows their father. A child knows their father. You are a child of a free woman. And you've got every right as a heir. Katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Your hand-to-hand combat is not with human beings, but with the highest principalities and authorities operating in rebellion. If you give me the TLB in Akwambia, we are fighting humans. We are fighting bodies, a people. Without a body. For we are not fighting against people made of flesh. Pastor Paul, unapona mtu mkutana na EGTM, akuna uchungu na kuinuka kwako, na kubarikiwa kwake, sio yeye. Ni mtoto wa Haga, anaongea. Isaka hutajua amani. Isaka utaendelea. Na remedy ni moja. Expel. 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 Sio mimi nimesema Biblia. For we are not fighting against people made of flesh and blood, but against persons, persons, without bodies. Maneno yana mifupa. Maneno yana mwili. Maneno yana damu. Biblia inasema hivi, tunapigana na watu ambao hawana miili, hawana nyama na damu. Without bodies, the evil rulers. Wengine wetu manoto ni mazito, tumezaa majians kwa ulimwengu wa kiroho, tumezaa majitu. Tumezaa majitu. Usikubali mteule mtu akapata kunenea kwamba utaiwahi kuwa. The evil rulers of the unseen world. So the prince of Persia, daktari, who was he? The prince of Persia was saturated words over Persia that Israel will remain slaves forever. Ilikuwa ni maneno kwa anga kwamba hautainuka, hatutawaachilia. Edidia, anga ya ngongi inasemaje kukuhusu? Vincent, anga ya ngongi inasemaje kukuhusu? Anga ya ngongi inasemaje kuhusu kanisa la GTM? Inasemaje anga? Mtoto wa Haga anasema nini kunihusu, mtoto wa mteule? Anasemaje? Mtoto wa Haga hanitaki. Mtoto wa Haga hakutaki, atakumaliza, atakuangaisha, atakuzika, atakuwa. Kwa sababu mtoto wa Haga alizaliwa wakati wa uchungu. Alizaliwa kwa majuto. Alizaliwa kwa kiburi. Alizaliwa kwa vita. Alizaliwa kwa bitterness. Alizaliwa kwa discord and disunity. The child of Haga. And today, I'm telling you, divorce Haga and our child, taking me back to TPT. And what does the scripture say, sir? Baba, watoto wote wa Haga ambao wananifuata, wale watoto wa Haga baba yangu alizaa na wao, watoto ambao baba yangu alizaa na wao, watoto wa Haga kwa uchungu. I'm not talking about flesh and blood. Babako alipokuwa kwa uchungu akipitia vile, nahangaika nikitafuta mashamba, vile nahangaika nikitafuta mali, ukute mtoto mmoja, nimezaa mtoto mmoja akija kupoteza hii mali, unakuta familia inauza ploti ya baba, wote wanakufa wote. Baba alisema hii yangu itakuliwa hivyo, atakayedhubutu kuuza na angamie. Hawezi, cause alitafuta kwa uchungu. Mama anapopata mtoto kwa uchungu husema nini? Jabezi, nimempata kwa uchungu. Ikapod, for the glory of God, I've departed. Every time we're in pain, including pastors, don't ever meet a man of God in pain. Umcheze. Atakuzalisha. Atakuzalisha. Be on your feet, please. Be on your feet. And I want you to pray one thing. I expel today. Leo utasema, wale watoto nimezaa na huu mdomo wangu, leo nawaua. Cause ni wewe tu uko na uwezo wa kuwapatia rat and rat. Thank you.